So, what I actually came out here for. I wanted to put a shelf on this tree over here, but of course we don't want to damage the shelf. So what I did was I took a piece of wood that's been split. You know, looks like it was some oak. And I cut a notch, two notches on either side, and I angled them toward each other. Alright, and what I figured I was going to do is, now remember I had an earlier video that showed how to make cordage out of velvet leaf. This is just jute cord, all natural of course, but I do carry jute cord with me. Eventually I'll probably switch this all over to being done in pine. Not in pine, I mean in 550 cord. Only because it'll last and I don't want to sit and have to keep redoing the ropes here. Or the supports, because that's what this is going to end up being. And I just did a quick loop knot. Now, and we'll double it over. See how much longer it is? That's because I want to have good strength on it. But what I'm going to do is I want to do it like this, so I have basically two loops. And then what I'll do is I'll feed two lines up into each slot. And I don't want them to slip together up on the tree. I want them to stay. Bottom supports. Now, which way do I want it? What do you need to do? And my improvised ruler. So we're going to go about there. Plus one blade in the center. Going to take, let's do this. This will realize it, but my camera had shut off. Apparently 20 minutes is the maximum video you can do on this camera. Now what I've done is I took and cut another string three times as long as what the board was. I mean, you can make it any length you want, but I still doubled it over so I could get the additional strength. Now what I'm going to do is I was just going to do it up over one branch, but I decided to do it up over two because what I want, number one, I want it stable. And I want it to be up here on the flatter portion, not on that knot down there, because that knot makes it too wobbly, I think. Holding the one end, because what I want is I want to feed this end through and create a loop. Then we can feed this through that loop, pull it down, and it can't come out. But now if I want to remove this, I can just loosen this loop up, pull that back through, and undo it like you're untying your shoe. Now, this side, there we go. Now I've got a shelf I can put my stuff on. I can put my spices, I can put whatever I want up on that shelf, and I can put as many of those shelves as I want up there for whatever I'm doing. Quick, easy shelf made out of stuff that you get out here in what you're doing. As long as you have an axe, you can split your log and shave it flat enough, and it doesn't even have to be perfectly flat. But then when it's not in use or you're not around camp, you know, you're gone from camp for an extended period of time, you can either remove it or just tip it. Now, you know, birds aren't going to be landing on it, pooping all over it, and any water that gets on it will run off. But that's it. You know, I do make sure that when I put it back up, the strings are in the slots. That keeps them from pinching together and creating a tip point. But that's it for my quickie shelf in the bush. All right, thanks for watching.